Hello everyone, welcome to the live class. So guys, today we are having another session on quantum mechanics in which we are going to discuss another very important topic of quantum mechanics, which is commutator bracket. So guys, commutator bracket based questions are very much expected in the exam and everybody should know about each and every important formula which we generally need to use to solve the questions based on commutator bracket. So each and every important discussion I'm going to do in today's session, and I hope it will be helpful for all of you. So let's start the discussion. But before starting the discussion about the topic commutator bracket, I would like to tell you about the Unacademy Plus subscription as well. So guys, I hope most of you are familiar with it. That is, by taking the Unacademy Plus subscription, you will be able to attend the more regular live sessions by all the top educators we are having on Unacademy Plus for your exam preparation. Also guys, there are so many courses going on Unacademy Plus by all the top educators. Like if I will talk about my courses going on Unacademy Plus right now. So there are courses on nuclear and elementary particle physics, clear? Then we are having thermodynamics and statistical physics, condensed matter physics, mathematical physics, classical mechanics. So on all these subjects, the courses are going on right now for which I am taking the classes. And similarly, other educators are taking the classes for other courses, okay, on different subjects. So you can check all those courses in the learning app, Unacademy Learning app. Next month, we will have the sessions on electromagnetic theory, electronics, okay, and quantum mechanics, along with that other subjects as well. So by all the top educators, you will get all the important live sessions on Unacademy Plus, clear? So guys, in this way you will be able to do the very good preparation for your exam, and you will be able to know about most of the subjects very easily. You will be able to cover them. And one more thing, whenever you will take the Unacademy Plus subscription, by using the referral code which is Anjali A Live, as you can see I have mentioned it here, so by using and by applying this referral code, you will get the 10% discount in the total Unacademy Plus subscription amount. And you need to write the code as it is, no space in between, apply it and get the 10% discount, clear? Or either this code or you can use this one, that is Anjali Arora, clear? So any one of the referral codes you can use, both will work, okay, but at a time only one you can apply. So either this one you will use, no space in between, as it is you need to write it, okay, or this one. After writing the referral code, apply it and get the 10% discount in the total Unacademy Plus subscription amount. So guys, after taking the Unacademy Plus subscription, you will get all these benefits. Also, you will be able to get the guidance by all the top educators for your exam preparation. So that's how you will be able to do the very good preparation for your exam. Clear? So now let's start the discussion and let me just tell you about the topic, commutator bracket. And this is very, very, very important topic. Prachi, see, not always, but you can expect, like, yeah, some questions of that kind. So it's important, like these are standard reference books which we consider, okay, and good one. Okay, now guys, let's start the discussion. So as we know, generally in quantum mechanics, we deal with operators, clear? So right now I will take like operator A and operator B. So let's say if I'm going to talk about the symbols, symbol we use for the commutator bracket. So that is just this square bracket. As you can see, I have made it right here, clear? So this is a symbol for the commutator bracket. Now how we just solve it? So guys, simple way to solve it is write this expression, that is AB minus BA, clear? So commutator bracket of operators A and B will be equal to AB minus BA, clear? Next thing, If I'm going to talk about some properties of commutator bracket, so they are like this. If you are finding the commutator bracket of A with B, that will be equal to minus the commutator bracket of B with A. Clear? So that's how simply you can just use it wherever required. Some more properties. If any time the product of any two operators present on one side and the next operator is present on the another side, how we will simplify it, how we'll solve it, what are the steps we have to take? Okay, so it should be clear to us to make the expression correct and to get the answer right for any given question. And these are the things, if you will make a command on these points, you will surely be able to get the answer for any question based on commutator bracket. Okay, if you are having some idea about the operators present there, it is gonna be very simple for you then. Next, see guys, in this case what you will do, which side the product is present, left or right? According to me, it is left. Clear? So what I need to do, one by one I will take one operator outside the commutator bracket which are in product. Clear? So have a look at this, A, B. And one more thing, wherever, in whatever side those operators are present. Clear? So you have to take that out on the same direction, on the same side. So it's gonna be like this, A in its own direction. Done? Clear? Next thing. And you can see, you can't write B on this side where I have written A right now, here, after just writing that simplification step. Clear? You can't write B here in place of A. You can't write A here on this side. No, that's something you will not do. Next, if the product of three operators is given, then what we will do? So guys, in this case, consider it in two parts. Either you can consider A single or alone and B and C together. Clear? Or AB together and C alone. So it depends on you, whatever you find convenient, you can do it in this way. So I'm considering A alone and B and C together. So then I will write it in this way. Take A outside on the same direction, on same side. Clear? Where it is present. Then, now this time A will be inside the commutator bracket and B and C will be outside. Clear? Now, apply the rule once more on this term BC, D because product is present there. So this time when you are going to take B outside, you will take it here after A. So whatever term has come like first out of the commutator bracket, that will remain at the first position. And later on, whatever terms will come out, you have to take them in this way. Clear? And if you will change the sequence, your answer may get wrong. So be careful about that. Clear? So that's how simply you can just expand it, write it in the simplified form. Is this clear till this point to everyone? But be careful about this point when you are taking it outside the commutator bracket. So B will come after A. Okay, you can't write B into A. No. Whatever is just going to exist outside the commutator bracket later on, that will just fix here, okay, or will be present here, this side. Done. A, B, C. Prince, is there any doubt? And anybody is having any doubt? If yes, let me know, guys. You can mention it in the comments. Next property. And similarly, if the product will be present on this side, same rule, but whatever operator is present in whatever side, you have to take it outside in the same direction. You can't change its direction. Okay, so just be careful about that point. Next. Simply, A with C and B with C. So A, C, plus, it was plus sign here. So plus, B, C. Clear? Even if it is A plus B, comma, C plus D, write it in this way. A, comma, C plus D. If you have already practiced the things so many times and you are having good command, in one single step you can write it in the simplified form. If you are just starting or your practice about these topics, then do it step by step so that you will not make any mistake. A comma C, then plus sign, A comma D. Even if they will give you the negative sign, just put the negative sign in between. Clear? So that's how you will get like simplified form. Next property. Generally, there is a condition corresponding to this, okay? But most of the times, we can even apply it directly. So you don't need to worry about that too much, okay? Otherwise, if you will follow the reference books like Griffith or Jaitley, you may also get one supporting statement there, okay? That will be a condition when you can apply it, okay? That's like commutator bracket of A with commutator bracket of A and B and that value. But normally, we can also apply it in most of the cases. So it makes the expression simple and easy. Instead of solving a to the power n comma b, the commutator bracket of these two, if we will directly write n a n minus 1 and the commutator bracket of a with b, it will give the answer easily and in less time. Similarly, if it is a comma b to the power n, in the same way you can do for that as well, okay? Same expression, in the same way you can write it. Clear? Next. Now, if we are going to talk about a, b, c, d, Karan, do you want me to explain that? A, b, c, d. Math will remain exactly same as I have explained for the product one. See, product, any one side product, firstly we will simplify either left hand side or right hand side. So let's start with left hand side and let's simplify that. A outside the commutator bracket, and there is also a trick to solve it. What is that trick? I will let you know. Okay, then next. Now simplify these two. it's gonna be C. And D. Clear? So that's how you will write it. So firstly, whatever has come out, that will remain at its own position. Done? Jashin, which one? If it will be b to the power n, then what will happen? Are you asking for that thing? Clear? Next thing, guys. Have a look at the next step. That is, if we are going to talk about the commutator bracket of x with p, then what will happen? What will be the value of x with p commutator bracket? Anybody knows? Del kar diya. Jishan, I'm not getting that point. Okay, so guys, it's iota h cut. Clear? Now next is p with x. What is going to be this commutator bracket? Minus iota h cut. Clear? Next thing, x with y, Jashan will talk about that. So basically sequence will remain same as I have told you in the starting. Okay, so if one operator is already present, next one will come next to that. Clear? So you have to write it in that way. I mean, the one that comes first, you have to operate it first. Clear? Now similarly guys, px with y. It's gonna be zero. Clear? Because momentum x component and with y, if you will solve it, you will get zero. Done? Now you know all these terms. Clear? Now the trick I was talking about, how you will be able to apply that. Let's say you are having the term . Can you tell me the answer for this very quickly, just in few seconds? Didn't get the answer yet. Very good, Prince. Very good, Karan. Very good, Joel. Very good, Charan. Okay, let's talk about it, guys. See, you know x with px. What will be the value of x with px? It will be iota h cut. Clear? But will y with px give you something? No. Okay, it will give you zero. So use the product rule when you are taking y outside. So y outside and which side it will go? This side. Clear? And x with px will give you iota h cut. So iota h cut y. That's going to be the answer. Like, you don't need to write all the expressions step by step. No. You just need to look at this. Is this combination giving me something? Yes. It will give us iota h cut. Is this second combination will give us something? No. Y with px will be zero. So I don't need to consider it. I just need to take y out in its own side and I can write the expression. So that's a trick. ओके हाँ जशन, ए बी टू दी पावर एन का होता है एन बी एन माइनस वन ए विथ बी, एन बी एन माइनस वन ए विथ वी बी, कॉमिटेटर ब्रैकेट डन. ओके गाइज, डू यू वॉन्ट मी टू टॉक अबाउट द एंगुलर मोमेंटम एज वेल? बिफोर टॉकिंग अबाउट एंगुलर मोमेंटम, लेट्स टेक सम ऑफ द क्वेश्चन बेस्ड ऑन कॉमिटेटर ब्रैकेट, क्लियर? एंड सम रिलेशंस लेट मी जस्ट टेल यू. सो इफ आई एम गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट द पॉइजन ब्रैकेट, लेट्स से वी आर फाइंडिंग द पॉइजन ब्रैकेट ऑफ ए एंड बी. I hope you all know about that. And we are finding the commutator bracket of A and B. Commutator bracket we find for operators. What is the relation between both? You can see that at most of the places, okay, when we are talking about commutator bracket, we are getting answer in terms of iota h curve, which is so commonly present in all the expressions of commutator bracket, not all, but most of them. Clear? So iota h could we get as an answer of commutator bracket, but in Poisson bracket we rarely get that. Okay, so in this case what will happen, you just need to divide the commutator bracket with iota h cut, and that's how you will be able to get the relation between Poisson bracket and commutator bracket. Sometimes if it will be possible for you to just do that conversion and you are getting the answer quickly with the commutator, let's say Poisson bracket itself easily, so you can go for it, because there you will not have to worry about the sequence too much. Agar aap Poisson bracket se karte hai na question ko, to sequence ko utna zyada aapko nahi dhyan dena padta jitna commutator bracket mein dena hota hai. To aisa karke aap conversion kar sakte hai and still you will get the right answer. Theek hai? So sometimes this relation helps us a lot to get the answer. Yes, Jashin? Clear? Any doubt till this point anybody is having? हाँ प्रिया, इन ऑल केसेस इट इज वैलिड. यस प्राची, या राजेश्वरी, यू कैन इवन राइट इट इन दिस वे, क्रॉस मल्टीप्लाई यू विल गेट द सेम थिंग. क्लियर? यस अपर्णा, विच वन यू वांट मी टू रिपीट? Okay, guys, see, there is nothing in A, B, C, D. Have a look at this. It's just same side, you have to take the terms, clear? So firstly, consider like this is a single term. It's like one term only, okay? And this is in two parts, first and second, clear? And now what you have to do? Take first on its own side, okay? And second on the other, you will take one by one. Okay, so it's like A, B, C, D, clear? And then plus, you can write A inside the commutator bracket, C, D, and B, okay? And then again, consider this and this as first term and second term, first term and second term, and then just work with these two terms again. So that's how you need to do, okay? And the point is, if we are writing, taking out something and you are writing it here, okay, that means after that operator, it's not related to commutator bracket, it is related to the position. And in the same way, here you can write after this operator. Clear? So sequence remains same. A, and then you are writing B here. C, you will write D here. So that sequence you just need to follow. Done? Yeah, let's talk about one example. We are having x square and p square. Clear? Let's talk about that. Ha, Karan, we'll do the questions at 9:45 p.m. today based on commutator bracket. Just a second, guys. Let me just read your comments. Jashan, is that clear now? Jashan, is that clear now? See, sequence is same. Nothing is going to change. Just by direction, things will not get changed. Done? Let's talk about x square and p square commutator bracket. Let's take one example right now. Guys, you all will also try it and let me know what you are getting from this. If you want, you can write it like 2p, okay? Or if you want to do it directly, you can even do it directly. It's gonna be px in the second one, last one basically. This is going to be the answer. Clear? That's how you need to do. And now you can even observe the sequence. Okay? If anybody will have any doubt, let me know. And this is the sequence you have to follow. Clear? So have a look at that. And now I think it will get clear because the symbols are changed. XP or PX. Guys, differentiation formula even you can consider. But when you know this like exact formula of commutator bracket, you can even use that one. Clear? And if you will go with the differentiation formula here, you have to write it like once, at least you have to use that product formula and then use that formula and a n minus 1. Clear? So then also you have to take two steps, either do in this way or do in that way, answer will remain same. It will not get changed. Yes, Ashwini, that's gonna be at 9:45 p.m. Clear? That's a special class. So guys, after this session at 9:45, we will have a special class. So if you all want to attend that session, you can attend it at 9:45 p.m. today. Clear? And for which you can do the free registration from the Unacademy Learning app. Because this session will be in the Unacademy Learning app. Okay, so for which you just need to do the free registration. Guys, now, tomorrow, again, we will have a special class, but that will be at 6 p.m. Okay, and YouTube session here will be after that special class at 7 o'clock. And you know, that's from 17th April. Today's special class is at 9:45. One more thing. Here we are going to have the live sessions on Unacademy Live CSR UGC Net channel at 7 o'clock, which I conduct on Wednesday, Thursday, Friday and Saturday. Clear? At 7 o'clock. So that's how like you can attend all these live sessions and you can get to know about so many important topics. Yes, Aparna? A, B part, which one? Huh. Guys, the condition corresponding to that that commutator formula, I will also let you know. Okay, basically it is related to the commutator bracket of A with commutator bracket of A and B. There is some particular value you should get corresponding to that. Okay, then you can apply it. Okay, so that condition even I will tell you today at 9:45 p.m. session. You can join that session to know more about the questions and the conditions okay, related to all these formulae. So I hope that the discussion, yeah, at 9:45 p.m. session, guys. Rajeshwari, almost regular, but I keep on providing you the information about it during the live sessions itself. Clear? Done? Done. So thank you very much everyone for joining this session, and if you want to know about the topic in a little more detail, because this was over half an hour session, okay, so these many points we have covered here. So after this there is a 1 hour session that is a special class. If you will join that session, you will be able to know about more important points, questions and conditions. Clear? So thank you very much everyone for joining this session. Also, as I've told you, if you even want to take the Unacademy Plus subscription, you can take the subscription. Use the referral code either Anjali Alive or Anjali Aurora, and by applying the referral code, get the 10% discount in the total Unacademy Plus subscription amount. Clear? So next is special class. Today is at 9:45. Tomorrow it's at 6 o'clock. Okay, that is another special class. So thank you very much everyone for joining this session. Thank you. Thank you.